awareness for the big proposal, because this is one of the finest schemes that is available for startups who are working in the initial stages of their idea and they want to build a prototype. This is a really good starter kickstart grant that can help them in developing their idea. So before we move into the BIRAC big scheme, I will give you a quick overview on HTIC, and we will also have Deepa talk a little bit about C-Camp, followed by an overview about BIG, and then we can hear from the horse's mouth myself on how challenges he faced and some of his pointers and suggestions on how you can write up your BIG grant proposal. Sumitra, can you please share the HTIC presentation? Any questions related to the presentation or BIG, you can post your questions on the chat box. We will take the questions towards the end once we have the presentation done. A quick overview on HTIC, Healthcare Technology Innovation Center, is a joint initiative by IIT Madras and Department of Biotechnology, Government of India. And we've been supported under BIRAC, the BIONS program, and we have multiple parts to the center. We were initially initiated and established in 2012 with the focus of doing healthcare research and innovation. That was the focus. And moving on, we've actually broadened our scope and broadened our ecosystem and building multiple dimensions to the center. Now we also have an incubator in place. We also have a SPARSH program, and we also support startups working in the COVID space. Recently, we've been awarded as the big associate partner by BIRAC to support the big applications. We have over 30 plus collaborations with engineers, clinicians, industry, and government people. Some of them are listed on the screen here. We have about 80 plus engineers, researchers, students, faculty members working in different areas of healthcare, from diagnostics, imaging, robotics, etc. And these researchers also are supported, also support our startups down at HTIC who are incubated in HTIC MedTech Incubator. We have 5 technologies on the pipeline. I'll be talking about them in a bit. We've executed 35 projects so far, and we have about 25 startups incubated. We have about 12 plus pre-incubated startups. So we do an on-rolling pre-incubation program to help startups crystallize the idea before they get incubated with us. Not by design, but we have a lot of experienced doctors, engineers, and serial entrepreneurs who are part of the incubator. We also have very young students and also faculty members from IIT Madras who have startups. This has also helped us in building one of the finest healthcare ecosystems in India, which is a combination of research and incubation. Next slide, please. So some of 4 successful technology translations that have happened at HTIC. The initial stint was with Shankar Netralaya in building a mobile eye surgical unit. It is a delivery unit to do cataract operations. There are 2 buses attached together with a vestibule connected. One unit is used to prepare the patient to do cataract operations, and the other one is the operation unit itself. So we've done over 14,000 operations so far, and 2 units have been commercialized. The other technology that got translated was in collaboration with Forus, which is a IE processing analytic and computing technology, which is ophthalmic screening device called Trinetra, which can screen your eyes and identify early stages of eye disorders like glaucoma, diabetic retinopathy, refractive errors, etc., without dilating your eye. The highlight here is that you don't require any dilation. This also has been commercialized successfully in 28 different countries, and 2.5 million screenings have been done. So the third product which got translated is also an offshoot of IPAC, which is focused on ROP, which is a handheld device to screen the babies, preterm babies, It is called Trinetra Neo, and it is focused on ROP, which is retinopathy of prematurity. This also has been commercially deployed in 9 different countries. This is just to give a sense of what kind of work happens in HTIC, so you get to understand the technology background of the center. So we've also built another quantitative device to do screenings for tests like T3, T4, HbA1c. It's a rapid quantitative test which can give you results for these tests in about 10 to 15 minutes. This was done in collaboration with J-Mitra. On the pipeline, we have four other technologies, which is building country's first endoscope. We also have a small team working on vital signs. We do some work in the robotic surgery space, and we also have a huge team working on POC or point of care diagnostics. Next slide, please. So this is how our research facility looks like. We have over 80 researchers working in different areas, from cardiovascular health to software, imaging, diagnostics, robotic surgery, a small team working on biotechnology as well. The other part of the center is incubation. We have about 25 startups incubated. Our space is designed very, very specifically to meet the requirements of the medtech entrepreneurs and startups. So you see the place is designed very uniquely and has a lot of support in terms of equipment, machineries, workspace support, and also other printing facilities for startups for prototyping, other printing facilities, specifically in medical technology space. Next slide, please. So these are some of the impact numbers. We have 25 startups. We supported 80 startups so far. We've raised over 5.5 crores of funding. The incubated startups alone have generated 100 employees, and about 70% of our startups are now funded. These are some of the programs that we are also supporting. This SPASH program is a social immersion program, and Kavach is focused on COVID. Next slide, please. These are some of the support that we extend to our startup in terms of business support services, networking, networking events and knowledge sessions. We also support startups in terms of funding with grants, loans, convertible loans, and also seed support from our IIT's Innovation Fund. And there's a huge, huge pool of mentors from IIT Madras, faculty, investors, and entrepreneurs who support the startups in mentoring and guiding them through the entire journey. Next slide, please. These are some of our portfolio startups who are working in cancer treatment, developing stress measurement solutions, some of them working on rehabilitation solutions, some of them developing AR/VR technology to train the medical students on orifice surgery training and minimally invasive training. Next slide, please. We also have some other startups working on high-end microbiome diagnosis and analysis. We have a startup working on improving healthcare accessibility and also creating a screening device for breast cancer. These are some of the startups that are incubated down at HTIC. Next slide. These are our partners and linkages. We work very closely with healthcare units and organizations like Dr. Mehta, Sri Ramachandra, Medway to help in clinical validation of some of the ideas, and also have a good network in terms of ecosystem players like Thai Pals who support the startups in reaching out and building their network. We have a very, very strong network of angel and network forums also, like Venturees, Indian Angels, Ritzo Forum, and Chennai Angels. Thank you. With this, I'd like to introduce you to Deepa from C-Camp. Deepa, over to you to take them through C-Camp very briefly and also talk to them about the big scheme. Over to you, Deepa.
Yeah, thank you, Pratishtha, for introducing me. Hi, everyone. This is Deepa, working in C-Camp as program executive for BIG projects. And could I present my screen?
Yeah, please go ahead.
Are you able to look at my screen, everyone?
Not yet. Deepa, you just have to click on the present now tab.
Can you see my screen now?
Not yet. Not yet, Deepa. Now we can see a screen.
Okay, hi. Let me just take you through what CCAMP does. CCAMP is Center for Cellular and Molecular Platforms. We are a DBT initiative. We were started to enable the cutting edge life science researchers and innovation in the country and to act as a bridge between academic community and the industry. We have a close association with NCBS and INSTEM. We work as a tri-cluster located in Bangalore. And we have two major arms. One is our technology platforms arm and one is our entrepreneurship programs arm. Under our technology platforms, we develop and offer access to high-end technologies and provide training. This is a hands-on training course that we have usually at CCAMP. And this is to assist the researchers across academia and industry. Under our entrepreneurship arm, we offer opportunities to innovators for transforming their ideas into impactful innovations, majorly being bio-entrepreneurship in India. And this has been our impact and outreach over the years. We've been able to deliver more than 4,000 projects to our startups. We've been able to train about more than 1,750 researchers. More than 25 organizations have been connected with us. We've had about more than 175 publications supported through CCAMP startups. And what we have helped or what we have done in the entrepreneurship wing is we've been able to associate with more than 170 startups, either in the funding, incubation space or by mentorship. Most of our startups have been successful in raising the follow-on funding. So talking about BIG scheme, it is a very initial stage funding that is given to the startup. Most of the startups land up in CCAMP through BIG, but they have successfully been able to raise the follow-on funding, which is of a higher monetary fund and higher duration as well. So more than 50 of our startups have received follow-on funding, which has summed up to more than 600 CR. We've been able to generate more than 575 employment through our startups. And we have about 15 plus products in the market in life science and healthcare sector. This is one of our program, BREC, in association with BIRAC and CCAMP initiative. So what we do in this program is we travel with a couple of mentors and expertise in industry ecosystem. We travel with them to tier 2 cities and tier 3 cities and spread the bio-entrepreneurship awareness across. There is competitions involved in this. There is a level of screenings involved, and also the ones who one who reaches the final stage get to meet the investor also in this program. These are some of our technology platforms at CCAMP. We also provide hands-on training courses from the chains provided with this COVID situation. Right now, we're only having virtual training sessions going on. This is another wing of CCAMP, which is directly under our CEO, the Discovery to Innovation Acceleration, where some of the innovations that is developed in the academia doesn't reach the industry. And we help foster these ideas and nurture them in CCAMP, and they're readily available for licensing. These are some of our ideas right now. So how do we help in entrepreneurship is by various levels. One is the funding, one is the incubation space, one is the mentorship, and one is acceleration. Under funding, we have seed funding for early stage exciting innovation ideas by partners like BIRAC, NITI-IO, NITI, and BNV, that's a Japanese private venture center. Incubate, we provide plug-and-play system. That is, we already have a furnished laboratory, and anybody who wants to incubate at CCAMP can start their project from day one. And we provide provide access to high-end technology platforms through pay-per-use basis. And mentorship, we provide both scientific and business mentorship by either conducting events or networking events or workshops. And we connect our startups to various players in the ecosystem. Acceleration programs are the ones for a little, not the early stage startups. It is for the ones who are ready for commercialization of their product. And we have CSAP and KSAP in place for this acceleration program, where we have a dedicated mentor given to each startup for guiding them throughout their journey. We also have BREC, as I mentioned earlier. That's also one of the acceleration program, because you get to meet the investor, and there are examples where people have raised funds after they've met the investors in BREC also. So C-Camp aids startup during outreach, early stage connections, making connections, helping them avail bridge funding after the initial seed funding, and also acceleration programs are provided to the C-Camp startups. These are some of our funding or investment opportunities that we have at C-Camp. Today, I'll be talking only about Biotechnology Mission Grant Scheme. Talking about Biotechnology Ignition Grant, this is a grant in aid funding of up to 50 lakh for not more than 18-month period. Whom do we support in this grant is young in startups, which means not more than 5 year old, individual innovators and entrepreneurs. Currently, the call is open. We are accepting online applications only, and the deadline for online application submission is September 15th. And I just request all of you to just note down this email ID. If you have any queries, you can get back to us or to Pratishta, and she will guide you through us. The key word that I want to say to everyone is please don't wait till September 15th to submit your application, because there's a lot of technical glitches during the last moment, and there are a lot of people logging into the portal, and there might be chances of it getting crashed and you not being able to apply. So please apply at least 5 to 10 days prior to the deadline. So 15 September, it is 5:30 p.m., not in the midnight like generally how other calls have their deadlines. So what are the potential applications under BIG? So BIG is supported for ideas with strong commercial potential and societal impact. And 18 months is given to you to provide or establish a proof of concept. Encourage innovators to take technology closer to the market. When we say Biotechnology Ignition Grant, not only biotech applications are welcome in this sector, we also receive applications in the following domains, be it computational biology, animal biotech, marine biotech, agriculture, healthcare, diagnostics, therapeutics, industrial processes and products, bioenergy, biomaterials, nanosciences, AI and machine learning. Even beyond these domains also, if you feel your idea is having an impact over life sciences, you can apply under Biotechnology Ignition Grant. Taking you through the overview of biotech. Biotechnology Ignition Grant Scheme. Scope and support, what is provided under BIG is, the project should not be, the proposal that you project for BIG or that you want to apply for BIG should not look like a basic research proposal. It should have a high level of innovation with commercial prospect. You should not be writing a grant for just conducting clinical trials or field trials or late stage validations or certification of the technology. Such things do not fit under the BIG mandate. And as mentioned, funding is up to 50 lakh, not for a period more than 18 months. Biotechnology Ignition Grant supports limited market research under the grant. You can also avail patenting costs, working capital during the period. Your travel can be planned through BIG for the project. The salaries or human resources that you plan to get into your project can be supported. Your IP filing, etc. costs can also be supported with BIG scheme. Talking about the eligibility, we generally have two kind of applications that we receive. One is the individuals and one is companies. Under individuals, the primary applicant or the project leader must be an Indian citizen and should be technically qualified with any basic degree, you know, undergraduate degree, be it BSc, be it MBBS, engineering. Any of such degree should be there from a recognized university, and the applicant should incubate in a recognized PBI, technology business incubator. So here it is not mandatory for you to choose C-Camp to be your incubation partner, but yes, you can choose C-Camp to be your BIG partner. You can be incubated at any place overall India and still be associated with us for the BIG partnership. If an individual who is a faculty or academician is applying for the BIG, they have to provide NOC from their institute. And if an individual who's already employed in a company is applying for BIG, he has to step down from his current position at when he gets the grant. So this is why this is mentioned, is because we expect, you know, BIG demands that individual to be 24/7 present for the project during the duration of the project. If he is an employee elsewhere, if he is pursuing his PhD elsewhere, or if he's, you know, working somewhere else, he cannot give that dedication. That's why we take a declaration from the individual applicant at application level, and then we seek his resignation during the grant funding level. So coming to the companies, as mentioned, the company should not be more than 5 years old. The startup or the company usually is a private limited or LLP that is considered as company. Proprietorship companies do not fall under companies category. 51% of the ownership should be held by Indian resident citizens in the company. The project leader or the project in charge person who's applying on behalf of the company should also have shares in the company. This is a recent eligibility clause that is added. Generally, the violations what we have in eligibility clauses, if an individual is a promoter, shareholder of a biotech company, or one of the partners in a biotech company, he cannot apply as an individual. He has to apply as a company, provided his company is having, I mean, it is falling under the eligibility criteria. And if an applicant company in which any promoter who holds more than 20% shares also has shares in other biotech companies, which is more than 5 years old, disqualifies this company to take part in BIG. Only this is acceptable if the person who holds more than 20% shares in the applicant BIG applicant company holds more than who's holding more than 20% shares in that company also has shares in other non-biotech company, then it is considered to be eligible. But if anybody is holding, say suppose my company wants to apply for BIG, and any of my promoters or shareholders who have more than 20% shares in my company is also having shares in any other biotech company which does not qualify under the company's eligibility criteria for BIG, my company will automatically be disqualified. There is an introduction of royalty on the grant since 16th call, that is the last call, where the applicant or the company has to pay 5% royalty on net sales of the product or technology till payment becomes equivalent to the grant in aid amount. This is applicable only when you go to your commercialization stage and there is no interest on the grant that you have availed, be it 40 lakh or 50 lakh, whatever you have taken. Right from the start of the production or right from the start of sales of your product, when you hit the market, you're supposed to pay 5% up to completion of the grant in aid amount that you have taken from BIG. Payment in case there is transfer of intermittent technology, or, you know, if you're selling your application to a third party to further carry out the commercialization, even then the royalty clause will apply to you. So payment of royalties shall fall due beginning with the first sale of the product, and liability to pay royalty will terminate upon after you've completed the payment of the grant in aid funds that you have utilized. 5% royalty has been paid till royalty amount paid becomes equal to the amount of the grant in aid disbursed and that was not returned as unutilized funds. So usually what happens in some projects, they do not use up all the amount that they had requested for their project. They might have completed it even before completing the 50 lakh that they had asked or 45 lakh that they had asked. So whatever you have utilized, only that much you will be eligible to pay royalty for. In case of foreclosure, there are other terms of GLA that is applied for the royalty. Talking about evaluation criteria, a big proposal will have various questions. If I don't know how many of you have already applied for BIG and reapplying this time. If you are new to BIG, the application would be a question and answer kind of a format. You will have like 2,500 to 3,000 character limit per question to answer. And these sectors which are mentioned here will have this sort of a weightage. So the unmet need that you're addressing in your proposal will have about 20% weightage. The value proposition or differentiation that you're proposing through your project will have about 20% weightage. The technical viability of your technology or innovation will have about 30% weightage. Team strength or passion will have 15% weightage. Business perspective will have 15% weightage. You will have to explain clearly what is the potential of your innovation. Why is it different from what is there in the ecosystem? And what is your view for the next 18 months for the BIG project duration? Is your technology a commercialization oriented, or do you have, is it possible for us to commercialize this technology? Has to be explained in the proposal properly. All these will be your critical qualifiers, you know, when you submit your proposal. These things, these are the key points that will be looked at, and this will qualify your proposal to go to the next rounds. Start with, you know, when you start your proposal, start with what is the problem currently? What are you intending to solve? How is your technology helping in solving that problem? If there are other people who are doing similar thing, how do you stand out from them? You have to give your key differentiators very clearly. We would suggest give this information in a tabular format and just you know, point out those things where you stand out from the competitors and list that out in a tabular format and put it across. What is your plan on establishing a proof of concept for your proposed technology? Has to be very clear in your project proposal summary. If you log into the portal and start applying, there's a point where there's a place where you can attach your concept note of the project proposal. We suggest all our applicants to take this opportunity and please upload your concept note. Concept note is something which talks about your project proposal in a concise format, you know, in a very brief format. So have these key potential indicators of your, just what I've mentioned in my early slide, have all these points included in your concept note, and please do attach a concept note in the proposal. The reviewer is reading through all the question and answers, and having a look at the concept note, it better registers to the reviewer that what you're trying to do, right? And you will have to also explain in detail, why do you require the BIG grant? What are you planning to do? For example, a startup might have planned their journey for the next 20 years or 10 years or whatever period. It has to be very clear to the one who's reading your proposal as to what you plan to do in the 18 months of BIG. That details have to be very clear. You know, what experiments you're planning to do, what objectives you have, what milestones you're planning to achieve, where do you plan to do, how do you plan to do, all these things have to be very detailedly explained. The technical aspects of your project has to come out very clearly in your project proposal. And also mention, do you have a social impact? Does the technology have a social impact? If you can populate some numbers, if you've done a market study, if you've done a survey, if you've just read through, please populate those numbers, give a graphical representation, or put up a pie chart, or, you know, any better way of representing than just writing words. That is also you know, suggested that you write in a way that it is concise and it is very very small and brief and to the point. Yeah, objectives and proposed approach. Start with the current study. If you've already had some preliminary results, you can mention them. Brief out your objective, the type of experiments planned, what you plan to achieve, and the details with timeline and what time you plan to achieve each milestone. All this you can detailly write. Novelty is an important compound. As mentioned, please list out your competitors. The table that I mentioned, you can put it in that format. Establish the differentiation factor. And if you have any challenges or risk factors involved for your project, for example, if it is a medtech project, there might be a lot of clearances that is required. In your project, whichever it is, you have to mention what are the risk factors or challenges that you see. And if you've done any preliminary work, please mention that also. Your IP, you might not have filed an IP at this point. I'm just telling an example. If a project has not filed the IP and you do not wish to disclose too much, let me just tell you, everybody involved in BIG is bound to a non-disclosure agreement. Your information is safe with us. Do not worry. We would not force you to disclose too much, but it should not be too less for a reviewer to strategy or project or technology properly. So it is up to you. Disclose how much ever you are comfortable, but disclose enough that they are able to judge properly. If you have any relevant references, again, check if you have freedom to operate in that area and then quote them also in your project proposal. Commercialization, for the commercialization question, we understand that this plan will change over the years. You know, it might not be the same plan that you have today that you will have a few days later, but it's okay. Whatever plan you have, at least it gives an insight for the reviewer to know that you're thinking through that line. So please mention whatever plans you have for commercialization, whether you want to sell your end product, you want to service out your technology, whatever it is, please mention under commercialization. Also, if you've done any market analysis, you can mention that. If you've identified your target customer, you can mention that also. It's ideal if you could mention that. So coming to the team, it is very important that you enhance whatever the team member is bringing into your team. How should it look? You know, how does the team carry weightage? What will be looked at when the team team composition is being looked at? Is the project leader technically qualified enough to conduct the project? Who are on board with this project leader to conduct this project? You know, be it scientific advisors, do they have the expertise in required areas? Not just the technical aspect, but also do you have somebody who's in the business who can help you with the branding, who can help you with, you know, guiding through the business roadmap? All these things will be looked at. If you don't have many team members, or if you don't have team members in broad areas, you can mention that you're planning to hire someone, or you're planning to connect to somebody in this field for this reason. So just make sure that your team looks like a complete team to execute your project proposal. Cover all the essential expertise needed for executing project, be it scientific expertise, mentors, business experts. Highlight your organization's partnership with other groups. If you've already started talking to industrial partners regarding your technology, if you've initiated some collaboration works, you can mention that also. While uploading documents, we suggest do not just upload papers, include concept notes, give references, tabulate information, and proofreading. It's important for you to proofread once or twice before you submit your online application. Better you can circulate it among your team members also to have a look. Sometimes when you are writing the project, you might not see it in a different view, or you might not notice the small mistakes that are there. The other person might be able to just get through that. Also, what CCAMP can help you at this point is, if you want us to review your proposal before you apply to the grant, you can share your final draft with us, along with the concept note and your final draft, the question and answers for each for your project proposal, either a PDF or a Word document, whatever comfortable to you. We will review and get back to you if there can be any modifications done to the project proposal. So I would suggest you please share it with us by at least 10-15 days before, so that we also have some time to go through and then get back to you with valid comments. So budget under BIG, these are the major heads that is there for a budget breakup. Under BIG, if you're asking like for 50 lakh, if you're writing a project proposal, there is a cap of not more than 30% which can be utilized under equipment, manpower, and outsourcing. Consumables, we don't have an upper limit, and contingency up to 5% you can take. IP costs 1.5 lakh, not more than 1.5 lakh can be accommodated for this. And travel again, up to 1 lakh. Not more than 1.5 lakh. Budget will not be very closely looked at the initial stage of your application, which means not at the first stage, but as and when your proposal goes through multiple stages, you know, when it's getting cleared at each level and going through the next level, before we award the grant, budget is something that will be very closely looked at up. This is the process in general, how BIG happens. Usually the call is open twice a year, once in Jan and once in July. This time it has been open, been open in August due to the pandemic. But usually it is in July, you know, 1st July till August 15th would be the ideal big cycle, but this time it is 1st August till 15th September. First phase is online application phase. Applications are accepted only through online, and the portal link will be given to you. After online application, that's after September 15th, the first stage is eligibility screening, which your big partner will do. This is again like what was mentioned for individual, what are the eligibility criteria? He has to be an Indian citizen. He has to hold a technical degree. If he is an academician or if he's working elsewhere, he has to provide his declaration, NOC. If it's a company, it should be less than 5-year-old. 51% share should be with Indian citizens. And the shareholder should not hold shares in any other biotech company. All these things will be checked at this point, eligibility screening. There's an introduction of PSC round, preliminary screening committee round this time, last time actually, it's been introduced since call 16, where we will look at the potential criteria for the basic criteria for the proposal to get qualified, you know, the unmet need and all those things that I spoke. Those things will be looked at, the societal impact that you're creating, the unmet need that you're addressing, the commercialization factor that is involved in your proposal, the technical feasibility of your project. These things will be checked at preliminary screening level. And if your proposal gets through this round, it goes to the technical review round. So if it doesn't get through, what happens? You get back the comments as to why this proposal did not go through this round. In technical review, this is again an online review round, where each proposal will go through at least 5 different reviewers. So say suppose your proposal is in agriculture. So 5 experts from agriculture, be it from academia, be it from industry, they will review your proposal and give scores based on various factors, the novelty component, the scalability component, technical feasibility component, etc. And the scores will be normalized, and we will maximum, if you have received good scores, you will qualify to the next round. If your proposal is not qualified to the next round again, you will get the comments back from the reviewer. After technical review, the next stage is PP round, where the applicant is allowed to pitch in front of the panel, technical evaluation panel. This panel will be a mixture of both industry, academia, also with the partners and the funding partners, and your BIG partners will be present in this technical evaluation panel. Usually it is a physical meeting, but last time, due to the COVID situation, we all had only virtual meetings going on. Usually this is the only place where you get a chance to pitch about your project. Usually it's going to be about 8 minutes of presentation and then followed by 15 minutes of Q&A. Before you go to the TEP, you will have some time where you can have one-on-one meetings with your BIG partner. We will train you about how you can modify your pitch, how you can better pitch about your idea, what are the key aspects you need to mention, what things you can ignore, what things you can keep in your backup slides. So we will help you to manage your important aspects of the project to come out in the first 8 minutes itself. And then when the Q&A starts, you can take up the backup slides and explain more of your project. So this thing will help you with. And after TEP round, if your project is getting qualified, again, qualification to the next round is subject to the cutoff marks, the competition at that call, how it is, and the funding agency's decision. And the last round would be expert selection committee. Again, if your project is not going through this round, you will get back the comments from reviewers as to what has to be improved, and you can apply for the next call. BIG proposal is a BIG scheme. You can apply as many times as you want, provided you fit under the eligibility criteria. But once you've got the grant, you are not eligible to apply again. Okay. And the last round is expert selection committee meeting. In this, what happens, only the chairs of each panel. So In TEP, what happens is there will be different panels that is divided into for medtech, for agri-tech, you know, for drugs, for only industrial biotechnology. There will be different panels, and your proposal, depending on which domain it is, it will get into that panel. So chair of each panels, along with the DBT and the BIG partners, will be present in the ESC committee. There will be only discussions about the cutoff marks and how the funding should go on. If there is any major changes to be done in the objectives of the project that will be discussed here. And once your proposal gets through the ESE round, there will be a financial and technical due diligence, which will also have site visit from any CCAMP member to your site. And this will be a thorough due diligence for your company and your budget, and justification for each budget head will be looked up closely here. Your company due diligence will be more stringent here. And the site visit will also be done, provided where whichever address you have given, where you want to execute the project, we will visit that place, and then you will be enrolled into the agreements and you will start getting the funds. So your BIG project will start from the day you receive funds to your account. That will be your day zero. I'll not take you through the other slides. We've come to an end of BIG presentation. We are open to take any queries if you have.
Thank you, Deepa. Can we also hear from Mr. Dilip on challenges he faced or some of his tips on how to write up the proposal?
Dilip was our 14th call awardee, and I would like Dilip to start sharing his experience now.
Thank you, Pratishtha, and thank you, Deepa. Good morning, everyone. So I'm Dilip Shankar, founder of Accord Innovations Private Limited. And I was just trying to recall that maybe a year back, I was similar to other participants who are currently attending kind of a workshop. Okay, it was a similar way that I was part of the workshop to understand what is a BIG. And trust me, I had no idea what the BIG grant is all about at that time. And I actually approached CCAMP because I was aware that there are other BIG partners, but unlike how do we choose our co-founders, in the same way, we need to choose our business partner, right? So when I actually spoke, what do you mean by business partner here is because CCAMP can actually bring in a lot of skills and experiences into our business. And moreover, they have an entrepreneur spirit. I hope you are always aware about what CCAMP and other CCAMP initiatives. So when I heard about BIG, I just interacted with CCAMP team. And they were very happy to actually invited me to the office, and we sat and they were able to understand about what was the proposal into. And they gave me a very valuable feedback. So that was the first level which happened, and they actually insisted me to apply for the current call, which is coming up. And so it was a call 14 of BIG. So basically the first step, as normal, unlike other innovators, we had to go and we had to apply over an online portal. And I realized that because when we apply and very crucial information in an online portal, because sometimes the proposal, the way we write matters a lot. And especially because it's not just only from one partner, right? So there are other partners. And they keep getting more than, maybe CCAMP alone may get close to 200 plus proposals in per call. But again, it's a so competitive proposals which carry forward ahead. And one key thing is we should be very, very clear in terms of ensuring that what is the problem and what is the solution that we are addressing. And importantly, when I actually submitted the proposal, I still remember before February 15, I always suggest you guys to apply before maybe 2 days in advance so that you may not have any glitches on the portal. And once you apply, so basically the preliminary data, what you need to upload is as per the form. So you need to make sure that the basic aspects are taken care of. That is your problem, solution, novelty, and also ensure that you have a very clear and crisp competitive landscape. Because people also wanted to understand who are the other competitors. So because there is also an option that you can upload such document. And very clearly, there is something called concept note. Because sometimes people also go through proposal, but also ensure that your concept notes communicate in a very simple language. So what is your problem, what is your need, and what is your solution, and how are you addressing that solution with respect to your technology? And being an individual innovator, I always had a worry that how much data I should disclose. But I realized because there is a lot of NDAs and other things which is ongoing on the competitive panel who is sitting there, who is reviewing this. So I actually disclosed the necessary amount of information which is good enough to understand the concept. And once after submitting the application, So the next process is I got an eligibility confirmation, and then we got a multiple reviews. So, I mean, interestingly, the reviews are not just only from the technical aspects, right? Because we don't know who are those reviews, but the comments are very, very general and very specific to the proposal. Maybe some of them could be an business mentors, or some of them are technical mentors. But I was very happy to get those comments, and that helped me even to reframe my proposal, because sometimes some of the points which we may miss out, being an expert, they will help us to understand and even to evaluate. And interesting factors, once after qualifying for the TEP round, so CCAMP also conducted an additional mentoring session. So where on an individual need basis, there are experts from CCAMP who actually helped us in terms of sharpening our proposal and also the pitch. So because hardly we get exactly 7 minutes plus 1 minute, so we need to pitch in front of a committee within the short duration of time, and we should convince the entire aspect of our pitch. So, and once after my pitch, within a month or 1.5 month, I got to know the result, and post that the due diligence has been started, and I never expected the process was so quick. And within a month, I was even able to get a fund. And after even completing my milestone one, after submitting the report, the funds have released within less than a week. So I think the process is very smooth, and the partner, I'm so happy that I'm closely working with CCAMP. And more than that, like they actually conduct something called mentoring session, because most of the incubation centers, we may assume that they may fund and they may leave, but no, but actually CCAMP is actually holding us since the day one. And they keep reviewing us and they mentor us. And as of now, I think I have successfully completed close to an year through my big journey. And once I also realized that, because once I was able to clear the big committee panel, and I personally felt that my idea has been validated. And then how I started my startup called Accord Innovations Private Limited. And along with that, quite interestingly, I was even able to get a couple other grants. That is Grand Challenges Exploration India and Pfizer IIT Delhi grant. So I personally took this as a platform which actually converts an individual into an entrepreneur, and they also help an individual to become an entrepreneur. Okay, so this is my personal experience and journey with CCAMP. In case if you have any queries or any questions regarding the process, I would be happy to help along with Deepa and Pratyusha.
I can see some questions in the chat box. A couple of them have already been answered.
I'm here. I'm Frederick here. Yeah, Deepa, yeah. Can I pose some questions? Great. I have been following CCAMP's for their works in life science, biology, pharma.
Yeah, go on.
So I know actually you're doing great in the other sectors, but do really CCAMP have MedTech competency in screening the application? And there are some questions regarding the system, how this grant is going to be screened, and what is the role of each of the big partners here? And is there any kind of application target that you have between each of the partners that BIRA gives you? And there is also one other good track record of the, like, which is a common saying, like the biasing of this application with CCAMP. You know, you try to have this common notion among. How do you come across these things?
I did not get your last question. Let me just put it across to you. Irrespective of whichever domain the application is, each application goes through a review round in which the reviewers are experts in that domain. What CCAMP does during the mentorship also, we connect you with the expertise, people who have expertise in that specific domain, be it MedTech, be it any other domain. And just to mention, we have most of the applications, successful applications, being in MedTech domain itself. We do not have any number that is given from BIRA that we have to focus on this many applications as such. No, none of the partners have been given that target yet. And what was your last question?
No, there is a common thing, you know, some of the application that comes from C-Camp or Biast or maybe who are incubated at C-Camp, you know, you have higher chances of getting the grant. So,
we receive more than 200 applications per call. Not all mm-hmm. the 200 people are incubated with us when they start. And a lot of them who have been funded throughout the calls, if we talk about the awardees, not everybody is out of Bangalore to be incubated at C-Camp or we being biased about them. We have mm-hmm. people who've been incubated at, you know, different partners of BIG itself, but taken mm-hmm. up the grant through C-Camp. So this is a wrong notion. I would like to decline this motion.
Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah. Hi. This is Ranjit here.
Yeah. Hi, Ranjit.
Hi. I run a healthcare AI tech startup. So applying for C-Camp. Can we do it through the Healthcare Technology Innovation Center? Will they help us as partners to C-Camp? Or what is the process?
Yeah. Let me take that, Ranjit. We are an associate partner, so you will select us as an associate partner and you can select any of the other big partners, just like what Deepa has said. So we are at the moment an associate partner. So yes, you can, if you want to be incubated at IIT Madras, then you speak to my team. I've already taken your email and then we will give you the letter of intent to be incubated.
Okay, there is one more point, Mr. Muthu, I wanted to ask. If we are already incubated at some other place, can we still get incubated at...
I will look at co-incubation, but that on basis of, you know, case by case, yes. If we can add value, as we can add value, yes, I would take the application and take it to the committee.
Sure. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you. That answers my question. Thank you.
Okay, Deepak, sorry, I've answered most of the questions in the message box, but you can take it from there.
Yeah, okay. So I see a question from Dhanushya Shri. Is it mandatory for an individual to be incubated somewhere? Yes, for an individual, it is a mandatory thing to be incubated in government recognized TBI, because we do not expect the individual to set up the whole lab for conducting his or her 18-month duration project. So it's better that they be incubated in an incubator, which already has all these facilities. So there's another question from,
There's only one question not answered. The rest I have already responded, Deepa. The last one is, do the co-founders of startups need to resign from the job before applying at BIG? You don't have to resign before you apply, but once the grant is given, you are expected to work on it full time.
So if you are an employee to a startup or a company which is more than 5 years old, so you will be applying as an individual, I'll assume, assuming like that. An individual, if employed anywhere, if only they are from academia or academic institute, they can give NOC. The others have to resign from their position. They have to step down from their position once they get the grant.
Hello.
Yeah.
I'm Omkar. I'm a PhD scholar from IIT Kharagpur. Can I ask a question to Deepa from C-Camp?
Yeah, Omkar, please ask.
I'm currently doing my PhD from IIT Kharagpur itself, and as my PhD topic, I'm working on a renewable energy. Clean renewable energy. The thing is, if I apply into this big grant, and if I got selected, I have to take a leave from my PhD.
From PhD, you can submit an NOC.
Okay, that's fine. Because I'm working with the facilities available in my lab, so that would be helpful for my, technology development. Okay. Thank you, Deepa. Thank you so much.
Thank you. question.
There's two questions in the
chat. Simutu has already answered most of
them. Danisha, they can unmute and ask you directly. There's two questions there. Danisha,
what if the project leader is associated with co-founding, right?
Yeah,
go for it. Yeah, hi, Deepa. So, what if the project leader is associated with co-founding a non-profit organization? What is the procedure? He should submit some NOC or something.
So it depends on if you're what is the position that you're associated with nonprofit organization that we'll have to look at closely, and then NOC isn't applicable here. NOC is only for the academics section, so we'll have to take this as a case per case basis.
Okay, thank you so much.
Sure. And there's one more question from Mr. Goel. At what TRL should the startup be before applying? So TRL. Any TRL below 4, TRL 4 is applicable for BIG. So it's idea to prototyping phase. Once you have a proof of concept established and once you have a prototype ready for a small scale, till that phase you can apply for BIG. Anything that is beyond that, where it is demanding mass production or going to the market or other levels, it is not applicable for BIG.
Hi, Deepa. This is Anushkrit. We are already incubated at IIT Mandi. And we are working on the prototype as we speak. So the hardware part of the device is in process. So are we still at TRL3 or will be at TRL4?
So you are in between TRL3 and 4. If you have some substantial amount of R&D involved still. You know, if you've already figured out everything, you just want to assemble the parts and give out your output, then definitely you're beyond TRL3. If you're still figuring out what parts to include and testing them and then trying to give a complete product, then you will fit into the BIG.
Yes, we are actually in the process. We have to do a lot of R&D still now. Okay.
So yes, you fit into the mandate.
Thank you. That answers my question.
Dilip, you wanted to add something?
But just like there's no other questions. It's 12, it's already 12, so we can wrap it up.
Okay.
If any other questions, please mail to one of us and we shall be happy to respond. Register, are you there? Okay, I don't know whether she's there, so let's wrap it up. Deepa, you have anything you'd like to say before we wrap up?
Nothing, Mr. Muthu. It was very nice for you to organize and give us this platform to talk to people that you're associated with. If there's anything else that you would want us to communicate directly, you can guide them through.
We will directly communicate with you. No worries.
Yeah.
And thank you for your time for coming. We really appreciate that. And any other questions, up the emails, you can respond to us. Yeah, okay. Thank you. Thank you very much. We look forward for you all to apply and be successful at your big grant. Okay, thank you to everybody.
Thank you. Bye. Thank you so much.